You good? Thank you all for coming out. Appreciate it. Good workout today. We beat the rain. We're a little worried about that early, but everything worked out well. And playing a real quality opponent this weekend. I got a lot of respect for Coach Hall and what he does and how he runs a program. And we know we're going to have to play well this weekend. That's why one of the things in football is so important, just moving on. You know, sometimes you sit back and look at past successes or past failures, and you're not going to be as good as you can possibly be in the present. So we just move on to the next deal, and we're excited about this opportunity Saturday at 3. Anybody got any questions?
What can you say about Pratt, Coach?
We're hoping he's going to be able to play this weekend. Find out Tuesday. So we'll find out this week if he's going to be able to play or not. He's doing more and more, looking better and better, and time's a good thing. Did a bunch of throwing, ran some unit and did some other things. Did all his drill work. So we'll just have to see. We get to Thursday, Friday. We got to see if he can do the things we need him to do and protect himself. And if he can, we'll play him. If he can't, we won't.
If he is deemed healthy enough, there'd be no consideration of saving until conference schedule or anything like that.
No, if he's healthy to play, we're going to play him. If he's going to have a hard time, I've heard people say, oh, you just get rid of the ball quick, hand the ball off, all that way. You're not running most of your offense. And then what happens if a guy, goes and blocks a guy to the right instead of the left? And you got a guy coming in and barreling in on him. So guy's got to be able to protect himself. That's an important part of it.
Is it a slippery slope when the guy wants to play and he's not
sure? Yeah, but that's my choice. I'm going to make the decision on it. He'd love to play. I mean, he's a competitive dude. I would have taken me about 5 seconds to talk him into playing last week. It wouldn't have taken much, but he was not ready to play. So we saw that on Thursday and Friday.
If he isn't able to play, how much confidence did last week's performance give you with Kai Gordon?
I thought the Kai did some really good things. It's always hard. It's kind of similar to when he got his first start as a college football player, playing the number 3 or 4 ranked team in the country when he had to come out here and play against Cincinnati. So, but I thought he did a lot of good things. Games are different than practice. You try to simulate game-like experiences in practice as much as you can, but it's not the same. You're not tackling, the speed of the games, that much faster. But I thought Kai did some very good things. I thought we, there just was some plays, some drop balls, some missed tackles that were easy tackles, missed some receivers at times, missed some cuts at times, missed some assignments. It seemed like everybody had about one, maybe two, so we just got to clean that up. We didn't play our best game Saturday, we were still in position to win the game if we executed down the stretch. We've got to do a better job coming out at halftime. We didn't do a good job of that week one or week two. So we got to do a much better job coming out in the third quarter.
Any thoughts on the – I know it's second guess yourself, but the cows went on, but on the onside kick,
it's – it's when it doesn't work, I second guess the crap out of myself. But it was a it was 3 minutes. It was kick deep, 250. It was onside kick. We had 2:56 on the clock, two timeouts. So I went ahead and did it. And if we would have executed it, our outside guy thought he was going to get blocked, and he didn't. If he just sprinted, I think the ball would hit him in the chest. Yeah, it didn't work. I wish we hadn't done it.
What do you remember from your matchup last year?
Oh, we were -3 turnover takeaway. Hard to win when you're -3. I thought we, that was a big part of the game, We had a pick six in there someplace. So we started off well, didn't play very good in the second half, but minus three turnover takeaway, it's a tough time winning those kind of games. They've got two really good backs. I think another guy's actually their leading rusher right now, but Frank Gore Jr.'s had an unbelievable career there at Southern Miss, and a big part of their offense is running the football. We just got to play leverage, and we got to tackle. We did a nice job of it last week. That was a back who's had a lot of yards, and I thought we did a good job of just not letting the ball, cross our face. And our missed tackles seem to be more on receivers than it did on running backs.
Of course, they celebrated quite a bit here last year when they won that game. You conveyed to your players how important the other side thinks this game is.
Well, we think it's important too, I know they do. It's a lot of history involved in this game between Tulane and Southern Mississippi, but I play every game. I want to win every one of them. So this one's the next one, and we want to play great this weekend. I don't think we've played great so far, and I'm always chasing that elusive perfect game, and it's out there someplace, and someday we're gonna get it.